Timed repeated reading is an activity to build fluency. Reading texts more than once supports students in developing how smoothly, quickly, and accurately they can read a text, which in turn impacts comprehension. Start by explaining to your student that practicing reading is important for learning to read. Explain that you are going to practice reading a short text passage 3 times. You can remind the student that the goal is to read all the words the way that the author wrote them on the page and to pay attention to punctuation. Also explain that you are using a timer to help the student see how smoothly they read the text at a good pace to help them understand. You might compare it to a runner who times themselves to measure how their progress is. Next, prepare a timer or use the stopwatch setting on your phone to time your student's reading. Use a familiar, short passage of about 100 words, such as one that your student read in a recent lesson. You will need a copy so you can write notes as your student reads. Invite your student to read the text aloud, paying attention to each word and the punctuation. Start timing with the first word the student reads. On your copy of the passage, lightly mark mistakes to aid your coaching. Stop timing when the student reads the last word in the text.
So, we are going to practice reading for fluency today. This is a passage that you've already read, so you've seen the words before, and you may recall them. Please carefully read, trying your best to read each word exactly as the author wrote it. And then we're going to talk about the reading so that we can make sure you understand what the text is about. I'm going to make notes while you read, so don't worry about me. Just focus on your reading, okay?
Okay.
All right.
As the student reads the passage, take notes on a copy of the passage or a sheet of paper. Mark words that are read incorrectly, mispronounced, or skipped. Also, note phrases or sentences that are read with appropriate expression. When your student finishes reading the last word in the text, stop the timer. Then, coach them on what they did well, so they know what things to continue, and coach them for accuracy, pointing out any mistake patterns and revisiting phonics and letter sound patterns and punctuation marks that are known to the student. Specify what to work on to make their reading more accurate or expressive in subsequent readings. Be sure to mark the graph to reflect accuracy, how many errors, and time, how long the student spent reading the passage.
Now, I would like for you to take your time in this next reading so you can really read each word as the author wrote it. Okay, are you ready to read again?
Yes.
All right. You ready? Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Have your student carefully read the text again, working to read accurately. Coach again for what they did well and for accuracy, and record accuracy and time on the graphs after each reading. Invite your student to read a third or even a fourth time, coaching in between each reading as needed. The final reading is usually the most accurate and expressive. Remember, providing specific praise and feedback will help build your student's confidence and fluency. Let's listen to this tutor provide feedback.
This time, I noticed that this word is through, okay? Oh. Do you remember what you said?
Thorough.
Stan likes to race through the water. And then here, you said can't, but this word is cannot. But Stan cannot leap. Okay, so you dropped down to 2 mistakes, and that's good. And you took your time and paused with all the punctuation. We're going to do it one more time, okay? And I'm going to again take notes while you read.
Repeated readings may be intimidating to some young readers. Offer encouragement and praise to support the students as they practice reading aloud. This strategy has shown itself to be effective in building fluency, which we know is an important skill to lead to stronger reading comprehension.